A great servant called Paul, he had this experience. What I want to do, I am not able to do. What I am supposed to do to my father, to the Christian community, what is my duty? I know here, but I am not able to do it. Why? And as a servant of God, what I am not supposed to do, I am doing. There are certain things I am not supposed to do as a single man or a family man, and I am doing it. Why? It is not my business to talk about somebody else, but I am restless. It comes to me. It's like one fellow was asked, "You made the retreat again. Why do you go for drinking?" He said, not me, Father. I didn't go. My motorbike went into that shop, Father. What I don't want to do, I'm doing it. Why it's happening? This was the struggle of St. Paul. Definitely it is our struggle too. And then in Romans chapter 7, verse 20, Paul reveals the secret. He says, if I do what I don't want to do, if I am not able to do what I am supposed to do, something is blocking me. Something is pulling me to sin. On the other side, something is blocking me, not allowing me to do what I am supposed to do. What is that? Say, I found sin ruling my life. Sin ruling my life. Yeah, mother from Secunderabad told me. She's a very praying lady. Her child is just second class, studying in a very famous school in Secunderabad. The child was 7 o'clock, they are supposed to be in the school. 6:45, the bus comes. Still 6:30, the child was sleeping. The son was sleeping. She woke him up, took the water to the bed, covered, washed him, put the everything the mother did, and he was ready, smart. He is alert that he is in the world. And then the mother took that feet, put the socks, and put that in the. As she was putting, the boy was crying, "Mommy!" Mother gave two, put first. But she says, she heard the voice within her saying, something is wrong in the boots. But she controlled that and said, no, it's time, put. Send the boy. The boy was crying. And the man in charge in the bus, he also gave to, what you are crying? Sit. He was crying, and the other boy thought he is sleeping. By the time the bus reached the school, everybody got down, not this boy. They lifted him up. He's no more. Inside there was such a huge scorpion. That boots, small boots. She never even saw that. Yes, boys no more. She says, I vaguely heard my mind telling me, spirit within me telling me, something is wrong in the boots. But I never heard. God speaks to us, but when sin is in us, it blocks. Then she realized, I am a praying lady. God gives vision. God gives message. Why did I behave like that? Then she realized, that she was angry and upset with her husband. She abused her husband and pushed him out of the bed that night, previous night. The previous day, the sin what she committed, when it came to her mind, she wept like a child. Father, I can't tell anybody, but I'm telling you. And wherever you preach, you tell what has happened to me without giving my identity. She wept like a child. Our body thinks it's nothing. Somebody loves me. My husband doesn't love me. My wife doesn't bother me. I can do whatever I want and nothing will happen. No. The spiritual realities are much true than the earthly realities. Our body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. And when we sin, as the book of Sirach chapter 21 verse 2 says, like snake it comes and bites you. Snakes and scorpions are the sign of the enemy entering into our lives. You have to be very alert. You have to be very, very alert. Sin is not as simple as we think. Because the enemy, when he rules our lives, it makes us to think nothing is wrong. It's okay. If you read Sirach chapter 5, you kindly take. It is better that you go through. There are five things the enemy who is at work in our mind, he says five things and tells it's okay. Tomorrow we can handle it.
Do not rely on your wealth or say, I have enough. Do not follow your inclination. And
so number one, with what we have, Satan will try to hide our sin. You have wealth, you have plenty too. Nothing to worry. Everything is okay. It's okay. It's not okay. Number two, it will say, you have your intelligence. You can handle it. Okay, it happened today. Tomorrow I will not do it. No. When we have opened the door, suppose now I have broke the window. And I have put the curtain, nothing is okay, I have closed it. But that is not a guarantee. Something can come inside. We have put the window, we have put the mosquito net, that nothing can enter. But if you open the window itself, the window itself is removed. Yes, that is what sin is. But our intelligence says, it's okay, I have put nicely curtain. I even punched that curtains. Nothing will happen. Don't think. Continue.
Do not follow your inclination and strength in pursuing the desires of your heart. Do not say, who can have power over me?
Don't say, who is that? After all, it's my life. It is mine. Who are you to ask? Who are you to say? Don't never say, my life is mine, it's my business, it's my money, it is my body, it's my beauty. What is for you? Please never say, you are not your. The Lord has bought you for a price. He paid a heavy price. His love for you is so much. He can't afford to lose you. His breath is in you. That's why he is mad after you. Yes. Continue.
Do not say, I sin, yet what has happened to me?
Another thing Satan will bring. Yes, I have sinned. What happened? Nothing happened. That fellow is praying. That fellow is also going through that problem. I have sinned. So what? What happened to me? Nothing. I have chalta hai sab logon ko aata hai jata hai. होता है. Never say, I sinned. What happened to me? Never dare to say that. Yes.
For the Lord is slow to anger.
Do you know why? Even after we have sinned, the Lord is patient, because the Lord is slow to anger.
Do not be so confident of forgiveness that you add sin to sin. Do not say, His mercy is great, He will forgive the multitude of my sins.
So some other people, Satan will prompt like that. Oh, God is merciful. Even if I sin, okay, not 7 times, 77 times he said, He will forgive. Tar baat mein dekhenge. No. Do not add sin after sin. When a sin has entered into you, be alert.